Hello and welcome to this really relaxing stretching routine for your back, your pelvic floor, and your hips. So if you're like this when you sit down on the ground, then your hips are tight and you need to sit up on the edge of a folded blanket. So other than that, let's go ahead and get going. Your legs are going to be crossed and I want you to go ahead and roll your shoulders back, sit up nice and tall, and lift one arm up. This is my right arm lifting up. Inhale, and then you're going to exhale, cross that arm and hold onto the opposite knee. So let your back kind of round as you pull on that arm and then lift the left arm up. Inhale and exhale, cross over. Now switch the arm. So you're reaching up, inhaling and then exhaling, cross over and then reaching up, inhaling, exhaling, crossing over. So this is just stretching out the back and the hips. Getting your breathing flowing. So you reach up on the inhale and then exhale and cross over. Try not to round and hunch your back too much. It can round a little bit, but not too much. When you round your back too much in this position, it can be hard on your pelvic floor. So a little bit of rounding is okay right now as you exhale. But try not to round and hunch too much. One more time, inhale and exhale. Last reach up and exhale. Okay, roll your shoulders back and sit up on your bottom. So I want you to bring your butt cheeks behind you like so. Really reach your bum back toward the back of the room. And for this first move, you're actually going to bend your knees just a little bit. Roll your shoulders down and back, hands flat on the ground. And if you can, straighten your legs. But for most people, you're going to need to bend your knees just a bit. The position here, this is called Dandasana. And the idea is it's all about alignment. So I want you to be sure that you're really lifted through your back and your chin is gently drawn in, you're lengthened through the back of the neck, and your hands are pressing down into the ground. So this is a very simple pose, but it's actually not easy. It's all about keeping that really nice alignment. And if you can, straighten your legs onto the ground while keeping that nice alignment, that's wonderful. Hold it here for one more breath, long and lifted through the back of the neck. Beautiful alignment. Now for our next stretch, we're gonna really stretch out the back and the back of the legs. Release the knees into a little bend. Keep that lifted spine. Grab on behind your knees gently. Inhale and then exhale. Go ahead and let yourself fold forward just a little bit. You can hinge at your hips. And when you're in this position, keep your legs together. And if this feels okay on your back, go ahead and let yourself round into it and really relax into it. Maybe you can straighten your legs down toward the floor. Keep the belly gently drawn in as you exhale. And then just breathe normally once you're in the position. Feeling that stretch of the back, the stretch of the back of the neck. Holding on underneath your thighs. Just relaxing. One more deep breath. Now go ahead and look forward and use your hands to help you back up. Now cross your right leg over your left and stack your right knee on top of your left knee as much as you can. So this right foot, I'm bending it and bringing it back. So the knees are stacked. Now for most people, just holding onto this position and sitting up tall is gonna be enough. And you're gonna feel that stretch on the outer hip and just sit really nice and tall, feeling that hip stretch. If you want a little bit more, inhale nice and tall, and then exhale all your air out as you fold, and either fold forward with your hands on the ground, or you can go under your knee like we did before. I'm going to place my hands on the ground. But remember, you can always be up too. You don't have to have your hands down. So just find the position that works for you. We're not going to be here too long. Just one more breath. And then go ahead and look forward. Inhale. Exhale, come on up. Now, carefully bring that leg forward, down, and then left leg up, across, and bring the knee over your right knee. So they're pretty much stacked. The heel is coming toward my bottom, and sit up nice and tall. Ooh, feels so good on the outer hip. Now, all of these stretches are really calming to the nervous system, especially when you add that forward fold. The forward bend is really soothing to the nervous system. So if you want to, stay right here. Or if you want more, inhale and then exhale, fold forward, hinging at the hips. Either holding on right where you were, or under your knee, or hands on the ground. Not here too long, so just one more deep breath in and out. And then go ahead and come on up carefully using your hands and bringing the feet together in a loose butterfly position. Hands behind you, spine is long, and wiggle your hips back and forth so you're not tucking your tail under, you're sitting up on your sitting bones. And flop your butterfly wings apart. And you can just stay doing this. Or if you want more, then you can hold on into a nice butterfly stretch where you're sitting up tall. Or if you can handle that forward fold, if it feels okay on your pelvic floor, then I love turtle stretch. So what you do for turtle stretch is this. Make sure your legs are pretty wide diamond. And you're gonna reach your hands under your legs and then flip your palms up. Make sure your bum is reaching toward the back of the room. Inhale and exhale, fold forward. This is a wonderful pelvic floor and hip opener. If you feel like there's too much pressure on your pelvic floor, if you have prolapse, this might not be the best for you, but everyone's different. And some people can do this stretch as long as they use their breath to move in and out of the transition of the movement of the pose. So always listen to your body. You know it best. You know your own limits. Stay here for another two or three breaths, just relaxing into the pose. Our last inhale right here. Inhale nice and big. Look forward. Exhale. Place your hands down. Walk them back. Walk yourself back up. And now we're going to go onto our belly just for a quick little counter stretch to all of that forward bending. We're going to come onto our belly and come into a Sphinx pose. So elbows are under your shoulders and walk one leg back and then the other. Stretch out those hip flexors. And then for this next pose, I'd like you to bring your right arm up. Come up onto your fingertips of this right leg or right hand. Now on the right I want you to look over your right shoulder and come up onto, tip your legs, so you're coming up onto your left hip. Your legs are staggered. Right leg is in front, left leg is in back, and you're kind of like stretching into the left side waist and the left hip, that bottom hip, feeling a stretch as you look over your right shoulder. Breathe into it. Just a new way to stretch that leg. If you want, you can even try coming up, but for me, that's too much. So, breathe into this. And now we'll come back through the center and switch onto the other side. So come up onto your left fingertips and roll onto your right hip. So your legs are staggered. Now my bottom leg is my right side and I'm stretching into that right outer hip, feeling that. Looking over my shoulder. One more breath. And then rolling onto the belly again. And then come down, bring your hands by your chest, tuck your toes, inhale, exhale, use your core and your breath and come into a brief little child's pose. So sit back and exhale, hands forward. Okay, go ahead and come on up. And we're gonna cross the legs and come down onto your back. So I always like to roll down through my side, not just jackknife down. We're gonna come into a stretch with our knee moving up toward the shoulder. So my right leg is gonna move up toward my right shoulder. So it's not just straight up to my chest, it's a little bit out to the side. I like to rest my arm on the ground and your left leg can be bent or flat on the ground. So just hold this here for a moment. Not too long, just a quick little stretch. Now, if this left leg was bent or straight, I'd like for you to bend it onto the ground and then straighten the right leg up toward the ceiling. Quick little hamstring stretch here. Roll out your foot and ankle. Bring that thigh and the knee toward your chest. Try not to bend the knee. Keep the leg straight and bring the leg up toward your chest as much as you can. And then bend the knee and cross it over. So you're in a figure four stretch. Now from here, if you want to have a little bit more, you can thread the needle and bring your leg up off the ground. Hold that figure four stretch. Breathing deeply. One more nice inhale and exhale. And then if the leg was up, return it down toward the floor. Now with this right foot, I want you to actually bring both legs down toward the right. So it's like your right leg is kind of dragging this left leg down toward the floor into an internal rotation of this hip. So it's a twist and a hip rotation. Your arms can be open like a T. If this is painful on your knee at all, you could always place a block or a pillow underneath this, this knee right down here to take up space. We don't often get this kind of a hip rotation stretch, so it might feel kind of different and weird, but it's good to move our body in all different ways. Okay, go ahead and remove that top leg, kind of untwist yourself here, and come back onto your back. Roll out your legs side to side a couple of times. And same thing, other side. So left knee is gonna go toward the left shoulder or armpit area. So not straight to your chest, but a little bit out to the side. Right leg can be bent or it can be flat on the ground. Breathing deeply. All of these stretches are wonderful for your hips, your pelvic floor, and also your back. If your neck is tight and you feel like you ever need a little pillow or folded blanket under your head, that's fine. Just make sure your head is resting on the floor. It's not up like this. Now let's go ahead and bring that left leg up, right leg up as well, and straighten the left leg. So hamstring stretch on that left leg. Keep the leg as straight as you can, feeling it along the back side of the thigh, and just stretching, rolling out your ankle, bringing that knee toward your chest a little bit more. Breathing. And what we're doing is we're preparing for our peak pose, which is coming up in just a little bit. Stretching out the back, stretching out the backs of the legs. So cross your leg over. We're moving into our figure four stretch right here. If you did before, cross, thread your needle and bring your hands behind your thigh and stretch out. But you're gonna feel this on your outer left hip. Feel that deep, deep hip stretch. Again, your head should be relaxed on the ground, not up like this. Bring it down. Breathe deeply. Feel like your muscles are melting away from the bones. Feel like you're breathing into any areas of tension or tightness. And then when you're ready, bring that top leg down toward the ground. And your left leg, you're gonna actually use it to kind of weight your right leg down. Pull your leg down. So both legs are going toward the left. So breathe into this hip now. Now we're kind of feeling this a little more in the right outer hip area and maybe even the back just a little bit. Arms are open apart. These twists are really good for your back. They're really good for your digestion. And of course your hip mobility too. One more nice deep breath. Now unravel yourself. So that left leg, just kind of bring it down and let your legs be floppy and floppy, however it feels good. And so our final big pose, our big peak pose here is plow pose. Now, if you have any neck issues, or if you have any heart issues or high blood pressure, you're gonna simply want to do this. Just knees to your chest. You can even have your elbows on the ground. Just do this. This is fine. If you want a little bit more, then you're going to bring your hands on the ground and kind of work your elbows and your shoulders underneath you. Then lift your hips and clasp your hands under you. This just gives you a little bit of leverage. Your bum is a little bit higher now so that you can easily roll into plow pose. In this position, don't move your head around when you're in this position I'm going to show you next. Keep your neck long and your head still on the ground. Inhale and then exhale. Bring your legs up one at a time and use your arms, bend at your elbows to come into this mini version of plow pose. You can have your hands supporting on your back and keep your knees bent. Now, if you already do plow pose and it's already in your practice, you can extend your legs and your arms, but this is only for people who are ready. I'm gonna stay like this. This is a great stretch for your back. And it's also really, really wonderful for your pelvic floor because it's taking the pressure off your pelvic floor in this inversion. So remember, don't move your head around. Keep breathing. Keep your hands on your back for support. And you can always do that modification if this is too much. One more breath. Now, with control, use your hands as much as you can and slowly lower yourself down. Carefully, carefully. It'll get easier over time. Bring your legs down and just let your knees kind of flop apart. So, nice job with that. Let's go ahead and go right into rolling and opening like a book for our cool down here. So bring your legs up and bring both legs to the left. Then open your top leg. Open, 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 and close your legs. So open like a book, open your hips, and then close like a book. Open like a book, and close. Open, and close. We're gonna end right here on the right. So open and then close your legs together. Stay like this. So both legs are closed to the right. Now open up your chest so your arms are out in a T. And this twist will help unwind any tension that might be there in your spine. So breathe deeply. Your head can look up, or you can look over your left shoulder toward the left, away from your legs. Go ahead and take one more breath, and then bring your top leg open, and we go to the other side just to even out. So both legs are now over to the left. Your arms open out into a T. Puff up your chest on the inhale, sink your right shoulder down toward the ground on the exhale, and just feel that nice stretch. I'm looking over to my right, but you can also look straight up, whatever feels good to you. Massaging your internal organs with this twist, breathing. And then go ahead and bring that top leg open again, both legs down, and stretch your whole body long like a pencil, arms overhead, wiggle your legs, point your toes, arch your back a little bit, arch, 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 reach, 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 and then relax. And just take a minute to spread out like a starfish and just be. Go ahead and stay right there. You stay right there. Please don't move. I'm gonna sit up just to say goodbye to you, but I'd like for you to stay in that starfish position for as long as you can. I hope you enjoyed that stretching routine for your hips, your back, and your pelvic floor. And please know that if any of those moves were challenging for you, then you can work up to it. You'll gain flexibility the more you do this. But always listen to your body. So stop or modify if anything feels like too much for your needs. And as always, remember to check the video notes to see more ways we can work together. And until next time I see you, eat clean, move every day, and you will shine brighter. I'll see you next time.